Hi there, ladies and gentlemen, back again for another episode in a land of the Sal. Yes, you're right. We are in one of the most beautiful places called as Saligaon. And I'm standing here at a junction which was at one time on the main road that comes here from Pilern and Beti and goes towards Parra in Mapsa. In front of me is the Chogam Road, which goes behind to Kalangut, and this way it is at Panjim. So ladies and gentlemen, like I told you, Chogam is Commonwealth Head of Government's meeting that was held here in Goa. And since we are talking about this, and we are going to talk about the churches, the temples, and a lot of other things over here, we have with us a gentleman, Mr. Ramesh Ghadi. And he has something very, very important to tell us. And for that, let us meet him and start our journey on this beautiful village of Goa called as Saligaon, or the Gaon of the Sal Tree. So, let's go and meet this gentleman who is a fantastic gentleman. Besides that, he is a Jatito Shetkar and an environmentalist who loves to preserve the culture of the land, and he is also a poet. So let's meet Ramesh Bab Ghadi. Ramesh Bab, kasha asa tumhi?
Asa baro, tumhi kasha asa. Fine. Tumka anga sir polon.
Thank you so much. Ramesh Bab, ata ja jagyar hau ubo ashillo. त्या तुमच्या सर्कलाचेर त्या सर्कलाचेर एक रोड येता जो पिलेनसून सकयल देंवता आनी तो पर्राव येता. हांवें एक पोन्नो मॅप पळयल्लो, त्या मॅपाचेर हो रोड वेरी प्रॉमिनंट आसा. आनी म्हाका एकदां याद जाता, तुमी कितें तरी सांगिल्लें रिगार्डींग दवर्णे. आतां हो रोड आनी हें दवर्णे, हाज्या बद्दल आमकां दोन उतरां सांग.
हो खूब आदलो पुरातन रोड म्हणून येता तुमच्यान बेतीनसून म्हापसा वचपी. पयलीं आदी पयल्यार आमकां तो पिळणच्या दोंगरारसून येवपी आसलो, त्या उपरांत तो रस्तो तयार जालो. जशी साळगांवांत हांगासर एग्रो संस्कृती आसा, शेतकऱ्याची संस्कृती आसा, कृशी संस्कृती आसा. जेन्ना हांगाच्यान लोक आपल्यो वस्तू घेवन म्हापसा बाजाराक वयताले, नाल्यार इवन शिवोले बाजाराक वयताले, नाल्यार कळंगूट बाजाराक वयताले, ते अर्ध्या अर्ध्या किलोमिटरच्या अंतराचेर एक प्लॅटफॉर्म आसतालें फातराचें, जाका आमी दवरणें म्हणटा. दवरणें म्हणजे दवरप, म्हणजे जेन्ना वजन तुका जड जातलें तेन्ना ह्या दवरणेचेर वजन दवरप. त्या जाग्याकूच एक्चुली म्हणटाले दवरण्या कडेन. परत मागीर सरमाण्या जें आमचें देवूळ आसा थंयसर एक आसलें, त्या फुडें पर्रा सायडीक आसलें, मागीर गिरी सायडीक आसलें, सगळे कडेन हें दवरण्याचें नॅटवर्क आशिल्लें. म्हणजे कोणूय मदीं थंयसर विसावो घेवंक शकता, वजन आपलें दवरूंक शकता, 10 मिनटां रावूंक शकता, कोण चार चकाटां मारूंक शकता, आनी तो फुडें आपल्या प्रवासाक वयतालो.
म्हणजे इन अदर वर्ड्स, तकलेर जर पाटलो आशिल्लो तो जड जालो जाल्यार तो दवरपाक एक जागो.
सारकें, पाटलोच न्हू, तो तणाचो पेणको आसूंक शकता, सारीचो पेणको आसूंक शकता, नाल्यार साक आसूंक शकता. म्हणजे कसलें वजन आसा पळय, तें वजन दवरपाचो हो जागो म्हणजे दवरणें.
तुमी एक सामके सोशल एक्टिविस्ट, खडे गांठ सारको एक शेतकरी म्हणटा तसो, तर तुमकां हाजेर एक क्वेश्चन विचारता की ह्या गांवांक अशें म्हणटात की लँड ऑफ द साल. आतां साल ट्री, सायलो ट्री, काय आनी कितें, तुका कितें दिसता?
साळ, साळीचें शेत जें तुमकां हांगासर दिश्टी पडटा. हांगासर आदली ज्यो भाताच्यो प्रजाती आसल्यो, भांगर साळ आसली, जिरे साळ आसली. साळ म्हणजे भात.
भात
आनी साळगांवान जितलें भात पिकता अजुनूय ह्या घडयेक, तितलें गोंयांत खंयच पिकना. शेती संस्कृती प्रिजर्व करपाक ह्या गांवां फुडें खंयचोच गांव तरी गोंयांतलो लागना, अशें हांव तरी अभिमानान म्हणूंक शकता.
वेरी गूड. दीस इज वॉट यू कॉल द प्रायड ऑफ बिंग एन एग्रीकल्चरिस्ट. आय वील नॉट कॉल हिम अ फार्मर, जस्ट ही इज एन एग्रीकल्चरिस्ट बिकॉज ही इज नॉट ओनली लुकिंग आफ्टर द फार्म्स ओवर हियर, बट ही इज ऑल्सो ट्राइंग टू प्रिजर्व द other cultural aspects of this. I am going to ask Ramesh Bab to show us, if possible, if it is there, the Dawarne and where it was located. So let's go over there. So, from that junction, after we spoke with Ramesh Bab, we came hardly about 50 to 75 meters away towards Pilen side. And he pointed out to this tree over here and he showed us something. So, Ramesh Bab, can you show us that?
Yeah, Mashayat. Lagi ayat. Hanga hai Davrana Ashale.
Okay.
Fatli ata 25-30 varsha ali. तेचेर एक झाड उगवलें ही झाडां हांकां आमी मयचीं झाडां म्हणटात
हां
हीं मयचीं झाडां स्पेशल कितें जाता बर्ड्सांचे ड्रॉपिंग्स बी आसता न्हू तीं केन्ना त्या दवरण्याचेर बसलीं काय तातूंतसून हीं झाडां लावप आनी दे आर वेरी कॉमन ह्याच झाडांनी एक्चुली सगळेंच दवरणें सोंपयलें
ओके
दुसरें
दवरणें सोंपयलें काय ताणी दवरणें तुमकां दवरलें लिपोवन दवरलें
दॅट्स अ गूड वे ऑफ सीइंग इट हें म्हणपाचें तुमची बरी तरा आसा एक्चुली नाल्यार हें दाखोवंकूय मेळचें नासलें फुडलें आतां ह्या मार्गा वयलें फुडलें दवरणें आसलें तें रोड ब्रॉडिनांक गेलें इट्स अ डॉक्युमेंटेशन हें डॉक्युमेंटेशन जर सोंपत जाल्यार आमकां ही हिस्ट्री दाखोवपाक मेळची ना नाल्यार पुस्तकांतली आमी दुसरी दुसरी हिस्ट्री दाखयता आनी आमच्या गांवचीच जर आमी हिस्ट्री दाखयना जाल्यार साम वेर वी आर लॅगींग बिहायंड अशें म्हाका दिसता बट आय एम हॅप्पी तुमी जशें म्हणटा पळय तें खरें आसा की झाडां ती लिपोवन दवरली दाखोवपाक तरी कोणाक तरी तुमी आयले म्हणून तुमकां दाखोवपाक मेळ
एब्सोल्युटली सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमॅन आय एम मेकींग एन अपील टू ऑल द प्लॅनींग ऑथॉरिटीज ऑल द लोकल बॉडीज तुमच्या गांवान जी असली दवरणी आसा रोड ब्रॉडनींग जाय आनी ही दवरणी ना जातली हें खबर आसा पूण तें करता आसतना तुमी जर त्याच जाग्याचेर मातशे फुडें रस्त्याच्या कुशीक अशेंच जरी एक ल्हानशें दवरणें बांदीत आनी एक स्मॉल प्लेक घालीत की ह्या जाग्याचेर दवरणें म्हणटा तें आशिल्लें यू वील बी डुईंग अ मायटी सर्वीस for the preservation of the heritage of our Goa. You agree?
Totally agree. Tumka muddam ani ek jago dakhayta jo dawrane aslo. Please,
let's go.
Yeah, chaliya.
So Ramesh Bab, after he showed us that dawrane over there, said that he wanted to show us something else in a village, in a ward called as Sarvane or what you know as Salmona. And when we came here, we saw this structure. So let's find out from Ramesh Bab.
Hangachan 15-20 meter jer mhanje 50-70 meter jer dongar suru jata. Mhan dongrar sun lokani adi jolo hadap vair kajiche dongar asa kajiche patle gen yop. An te patle khai dortolo taka lagun jantyani hanga sar eka davarnyachi vyavastha kelli.
Okay.
Te he davarne. Okay. मग कालांतरान ते दवरणें पडलें डिस्ट्रॉय जालें मात हांगासरल्या थळाव्या लोकांनी आपली संस्कृती जतन करपाक ह्या एक रेप्लिका तयार केली तशें न्ही म्हणल्यार आदल्या दवरण्यांक अशें शिमीट काडलेली बी नासताली आनी इतलें तें चकचकीत नासतालें फातराचें आसतालें मात एनी वे तांकां सल्यूट ह्या थळाव्या लोकांक हांगासरल्या वाड्या वयल्या लोकांक तेंच्यांनी मुद्दम दाखोवपाक तरी मेळटलें की दवरणें म्हणून तेचो वापर ना जालो तरी एक दवरणें म्हणून लोकेशनाचेर आसा
सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमॅन Though this may not be the original Dawarne, the local people have to be credited for having created another one, though with a little bit of cement, and preserving that memory of the ancestors who in their wise wisdom to support those people who were hardworking on the mountains, on the hills over here, carrying the firewood, those baskets of cashew fruit, तुम्ही फेणी पियेता आसतना यू नेवर थिंक ऑफ ऑल दीस प्रॉब्लम्स बट आवर एन्सेस्टर्स डीड एन्ड वेन दे वर गोईंग डावन दे वूड रेस्ट ओवर हियर बाय किपींग इट ऑन दीस दवरने एन्ड देन गो हेड सो थँक्यू रमेश बाब फॉर दीस एन्टायर
माय इट्स माय प्लेजर सो देव बरें करूं थँक्यू
आनी
तुमच्या चॅनलाक
थँक्यू सो दॅट फॉर यू लेडीज एन्ड जेंटलमॅन इज रमेश घाडी पोएट एनवायरमेंटल एक्टिविस्ट हॉर्टिकल्चरिस्ट एन्ड एग्रीकल्चरिस्ट एन्ड This is the Dawarne. Let me just find out whether he remembers a few lines of his own poem. Tumka ek khaychi ek poet poem tumchi mhanu mate lanchi
janna bhata vikun sopli vikun vikun janna sagli bhata vikun sopli building chi biya thodi shatan horopli holu holu shatan zale building che ran paisa deshak palun gele kugulache gaan paisa deshak palun gele kugulache gaan कापून कापून कसायांनी दोंगर रानां कापलीं थोडीं बिल्डिंगांनी थोडीं दोंगरार रोवन धांपलीं आनी इट गो सो ऑन
आय थिंक देर कॅन बी नो बेटर पोयम दॅन दीस for the state of Goa that we are in. Listening to his words, I am fired up more to preserve the heritage of my land. So, ladies and gentlemen, after having spoken to Mr. Ramesh Ghadi, seeing the Dovarnis over here, we had to take the help of someone else to show us the remaining part of it. And who better than one of Saligaon's most famous daughter, Clarice Waz. Now, Clarice Waz was recommended by a lot of people to me that you must take her and she is going to show you around. And I'm sure she will do a good job. But then I realized that this Clarice Waz is somebody who has a talent right here in Saligaon, and something I personally say is unique art that is there in the world. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's not waste time. Let's go in and see and meet Mrs. Clarice Waz. Come on.
Good morning, Clarice.
When she brought us up here, she showed us the art, the secret of our art. And ladies and gentlemen, when you see this secret, don't tell this to anybody else except tell them to watch My Goa. And the Saligaon episode is going to really bowl you over, because look at the bowl that she is painting. This is called as injection art. And what she can do with that injection, you all know what you all do with the injection, but look at what she is doing with the injection. And I'm going to show you a few pieces of her art. And she has presented three huge paintings to the My Dedeo's Church at Saligaon. We will see those too. But just look at this. This is amazing. Did you ever believe that an injection could do this? When you see an injection, all it reminds you is of pain, crying, and shouting and being held, and then the man in white coming and giving you that dose in your arm. While this lady in white, who was earlier a nurse, and she picked up that thing that gave pain to give relief to the world. Ladies and gentlemen, for you all, Clarice Waz. You think Clarice Bai is going to help us because of this particular thing, what we are doing for her? No. We were totally bowled over. You can see these bowls, no? Not by just these paintings, but the style of her paintings. The difference as compared to any other painter. And you would like to know how and what painting she has done. She has put the entire spirit of Saligaon in whatever these graphics are. And we bring heritage to you. I just could not move out of this house without bringing to you the heritage that has not been photographed, but painted with an injection. And here you are, ladies and gentlemen, Clarice Waz for you. Correct myself. It is not injection painting. Injection is for people like me who make mistakes. This, as per Clarice Waz, is syringe painting. Remember that. Difference between injection and a syringe. This is the syringe injection technique that she uses for painting this. A cow, can you believe it, coming out of the syringe? Let's go down, because we have to go now into Saligaon with her. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen, on our way with Clarice Bai to show you the village of Saligaon. You are going to be enthralled with this. So Clarice Bai, on way, let's conquer Saligaon. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been brought here by our friend Mrs. Clarice Vaz to a lovely chapel of Saint Anna. That is in the ward of
Muddavadi.
In Muddavadi. And this is the first chapel that you will get when you are going from Panjim to Kalangut via Saligaon. So let's go in and see what beauty it has in store for all of us. So here, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the chapel of Saint Anna, and we have with us Mrs. Clarice Vaz. Samke khode gat Saligaonkar, and she is going to tell us something a little more about it. But before that, I want you to see the altar of this. Mesmerizing is the word, and more mesmerizing for me is the pulpit. So let's take a walk down there and see what this thing is. And Clarice is going to just feed in the information, because not only that I don't know, because you also don't know. So let's listen to Clarice as we go over there. Come. One of my passions when I visit any of the chapels or the churches in Goa is to find out whether they have a pulpit. What is a pulpit? What you see behind me is a pulpit. Now, on feast days, the priest would come up here and then he would say the mass, or he would do the service, or possibly when people were sitting on the choir balcony there, he would come out and say the mass. But here, when I came to the Saint Anna Chapel in Saligaon, I found that this is an amazing piece of artistry of our carpenters. Just look at this, ladies and gentlemen. This chapel of Saint Anna is the first thing that you will see when you are about to enter Saligaon from Sangolda, that is on the Chogyam Road. When you are passing by here, look at the exterior. Immediately, you will know that there is something beautiful inside. And what's that inside? Let's find out from our friend Clarice Vaz. Clarice Bai, could you tell us a little bit about when this chapel could have been instituted here, and what we see on the altar over there?
So we have here an ancient chapel that is built in the late 18th century, say roughly around 1792. But it has been inaugurated in 1843. And it is one of the oldest chapels in Saligaon, and it has some beautiful wooden work and carved work here with pillars, and there are three altars. We even have a parallel row gallery here and a pulpit, which is very unusual for a chapel, you know. So basically we are coming to something that's nearly almost 200 plus years, you know,
yes.
In this chapel. So we have here the altar of Sacred Heart of Jesus, another one dedicated to the Sacred Heart of Mary, and then in the on the top we have in the main niche we have Santa Ana, the patroness of this chapel. To her left is Saint Joseph, and then there is Saint Sebastian. On the top again we have the crucifix, and then Saint Joseph and Mother Mary, and we have Our Lady of Remedios. This is very rare to have this statue here. And we have also Saint Bartholomew on the right hand side. So this chapel is still well maintained by the people of three wards, that is Don Vado, Molembat, and Tabra Vado. And there's another one, Mudda Vado. And they celebrate the feast of Santa Ana, which is actually due in a few days' time. Yes.
Okay. But actually speaking, Santa Ana is the grandmother of Jesus Christ.
Mother of Mary.
And today, actually, on 27th,
26th.
Is on the 26th is her
grandparents' day.
Okay.
Yes, and it is actually her feast.
Huh.
So they celebrate both together, Santa Ana and Saint Joachim as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
There is a choir balcony over here. Now, it is said that earlier the choir would not stand down, they would be singing from top. One question here, do you have a very good choir here?
Oh, yes. The choir is down now, but in the old days, the resounding sound used to give it a different flavor. And it was really heartwarming to see them singing in different tones and different voices. So. And most of them knew to play a musical instrument.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, so our visit here comes to an end on a musical note. Let's move to the next chapel. Gentlemen, in our discovery route of Saligaon, we were directed by Captain Clarice to a ward called as Arari. Now, Arari is a place that I love very much. I have just shown you the Saligaon Institute. And recently, every Tuesday, there used to be the Saligaon market outside, which promoted the wealth of Saligaon village through the people firsthand. And I can tell you, it became famous all over the world. Now, very close to the Saligaon Institute, we saw a lovely chapel over here, but most of the time, it is to be closed. We had our captain, Clarice, who has a lot of contacts over here, and she brought us in contact with Mrs. Merlin Francis, the president of the St. Cajetan Chapel at Arari. So welcome to my program, My Goy.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
When I walked inside your place, thanks to you, I was really taken up by the wonderful art that I see over here in the form of the altar, and I am always in love with the pulpits. Can you tell us a little bit about this chapel?
This chapel of St. Cajetan was built in the year 1655 in due course of time, we had to renovate the chapel in 1907.
Hmm.
So, ever since, we've had efficient committee members who have looked after the chapel, because Saint Cajetan is a patron saint of many people of Arari. And believe me, he really does wonders and miracles.
You can see that passion out there on her face. Information, the Theatines landed in Goa somewhere around 1640. And they were earlier in Bijapur. And they constructed one of the most beautiful churches in Goa. That is St. Cajetan's Church at Old Goa. I am bowled over with this craftsmanship. You can see the craftsmanship over here. Saligao must have been really, really having a lot of artists. And ladies and gentlemen, what is very important is you require not just pieces like this, but you require people like them to take care of it. Because when she says this was in 1655, we are talking 400 years back, almost 400 years back. And for 400 years to keep this particular thing in this way, whoops, salutes to you, ma'am. Ma'am, when do you celebrate your feast over here?
We celebrate our feast on the first Sunday of August, and this year it falls on the 7th of August, which is celebrated with great pomp and gaiety. We have the fair outside, we have the Alvarad. So it is really a very traditional feast of our Vado, Arari.
Very good. I'm going to ask you a personal question. Are you from Saligao or have you come into Saligao?
I'm imported into Saligao.
You are from?
I'm from Verna.
You're from Verna?
Verna, Salsit.
Okay. From the time that you came here to now, you must have seen this fair.
Yes.
No? Okay. What do you remember then which you are missing today, or which you think that the new generation is missing today?
Oh, I miss the balloons. You hardly find any balloon man here, because when we were young and we used to go to our for the fair, we used to get 25 paise. But otherwise, the sweets we get, we are the same. We also had people who would come and sell meats. So we would get meat the previous day, and then followed by the fair, you know, the following day. However, we have a small fair with about 4-5 stalls that come.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a coincidence. I loved the way she told me about her reminiscences about the balloons. But she talked about meat sellers coming here and selling meat over here. Just as a huge coincidence, today morning as I was waiting for my cameraman, Mr. Tushizas, who just behind this camera, there were people who are catching a pig, and I realized that a feast is coming close by. But I didn't see that next part where his poor fellow is put on a cycle and he's taken over there. But yes, lovely memories, ma'am. Thank you so much for your time that you have given to us, and my thanks to your committee. And I hope that we will be able to see these things as the years goes by. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thanks for all your passion and the trouble that you take to keep our history take it into posterity. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, ma'am.